Hey friends, hope you're having a good Wednesday. Just back from seed camp myself. I left the team a little bit early. They continue and will finish up seed camp today. But we had a good, my time there, great couple of days. And we had to do seed camp a little differently this year. But with Judson closing and post-pandemic, kind of dealing with a number of those issues. But we're able to work with the school systems down in Marion. And that was a really successful approach. So we were really glad. We weren't really sure if Sowing Seeds of Hope and Alabama CBF were going to be able to pull off seed camp this year. So was excited to see it happening and really glad that our church could be a part of it. I think there were probably near 25, 30 folks in our total team, and that was from several churches. But our group will be coming back this afternoon, Wednesday evening, and probably in need of some rest, but also bringing along a great experience with the folks down there in Marion and the children, and they just did some really great offerings and activities. While that group was away in Marion, we also have our youth, 7th through 12th graders, away at Furman University with Tyler and those adults chaperoning youth camp. So, and all the reports we get back have been glowing. So they're having a great time, wonderful experience, a lot of fun, as is always the case at youth camp, and some meaningful time together, some times of Bible study and worship, and just the kind of things that we'd hope for them. And just around the corner, this Saturday, I believe it is, our children leave for their children's camp, which is also with Passport. And so Nancy will be taking her group of adults and children and making their way several hours over in Georgia. I think it's east of Atlanta is where their camp is holding, if I'm remembering correctly. So we've got teenagers coming back this weekend and children going out this weekend. So let's continue to remember all our folks who are out doing their summer activities and camping with church functions and such. Let's see, a couple other just updates while I have you. I think, I know I mentioned to a number of you, I'm not sure through this method or certainly in person, our search for our new food service director. And this past Sunday, I was communicating to folks that we've hired that individual. So we're excited for that. Her name is Leslie Cantrell. And Leslie will be joining us in another week or 10 days. And we'll have things in place so that we can begin food service again for our Child Development Center daily, and also our Wednesday session programming that returns in August. So keep an eye out for Leslie and be sure and welcome her. We're real excited to have her bring her talents and gifts to be among us here at the church. As I mentioned, Wednesday programming, those Wednesday sessions, those will get underway in August. The August 4th, we'll have a business meeting on Wednesday night, and then the 11th, we'll all come back for just a good time together and kind of from there have some different options going forward. But look for some promotion on that that gives you an idea of what kind of activities and Bible studies and groups that will be a part of our midweek programming this fall. I hope you'll look for a way to connect with that. There's some really great things coming through that, and I've got to say that Laura Tadlock has been working with us part-time this summer and helping us, a church member, Laura, to schedule and put together our Wednesday programming for adults. And she's done a fantastic job, and that's been a great help to us. And I'm looking forward to the Wednesdays kicking off. It'll be nice to be back around the tables together. That also, Wednesday nights also means the return of music and missions, and that will get underway in short order as well with our children back in their regular Wednesday programming with a new enthusiasm since it's been a while since we've been together. Remember as well, this Sunday after worship, we'll have that moment of called business meeting. You hopefully received your notification by email of the nominating committee's report for the search committee to be presented to the congregation for their consideration. So that will come before the church this Sunday after worship, and we'll have that moment of business meeting together this coming Sunday. There are other things on the horizon, but maybe that's enough for now as far as what's happening immediately and what's right around the corner. So many good things developing right now and great energy in the church. If you haven't made your way back, we certainly look forward to seeing you soon. And let me, before we go though, let me update you on our prayer list. We do have a few folks who are remaining in the hospital currently. A new addition, Carolyn Dutton, and Bob Hardy has, he was in rehab, but he is back at Grandview now. And Gaynell Pinson remains in the hospital as well. She's got a fair recovery ahead of her. And in rehab, Carolyn Kane and Peggy Jones. So remember those, and we may have mentioned last week, but continue to have in your thoughts and prayers Henry White and his family, as he lost his mother a week and a half ago, and also Libby Pittman and her family in the loss of her father last week as well. I think that's it as far as the update. I'm glad we can do this and glad to give you the update, and I look forward to seeing you soon. Hopefully even this Sunday. Have a good day.